Hi everyone, I'm Jen Pepsinella, the manager of the Green Recovery Connect Help Desk with the Environment and Disaster Management, or EDM, program at WWF, and I want to welcome you to this presentation on Building Material Selection and Use, an environmental guide, the BMIG. This short session will focus on the guide and ways you can get involved in this effort. I'm also joined by Vidushi, a current graduate student studying chemical engineering at Northwestern University's McCormick School and a BMIG intern. Vidushi joined our program this past summer to help develop an expanded international version of the guide. Dr. Misika Hetarachi could not join us today, but he's a civil and environmental engineer by training and was instrumental in the development and expansion of this guide. For some background, and for those of you not familiar with WWF and the EDM program, we've been in operation since 2005, shortly after the Indian Ocean tsunami in 2004. Our work primarily focuses on three program areas. The first is a Green Recovery and Reconstruction Training Toolkit, the GRT. We developed and launched the GRT in 2010 with the American Red Cross and has since been used in over 20 countries. The GRT's available in Spanish, English, and Bahasa Indonesia. Our most recent project, the second program area, is Natural and Nature-Based Flood Management, a Green Guide. We developed this in partnership with the U.S. Office of Foreign Disaster Assistance, and this guide and training program supports flood management that uses a combination of policy, natural nature-based methods, and traditional engineering to maximize the benefits of flooding while reducing risk. The third and last program area of our work is the Green Recovery Connect, a 24/7 help desk that connects disaster management practitioners from around the world with environmental specialists for project-specific support and guidance. GRT trainings in Nepal after the 2015 earthquake led to the development of the Building Material Guide. One of the top priorities determined from post-disaster assessments was the need for promoting safe building materials, along with reusing and recycling disaster debris. The demand for specific guidance on environmentally responsible building material procurement is what led WWF to develop a Nepal-specific version of the BMIG. The social and environmental impacts of building material extraction are well understood and documented by the reconstruction and building construction communities. However, they exist outside of Nepal as well. We built upon the existing Nepal-specific guidance and developed an international version as well as a Sri Lanka-specific version to better document these context-specific challenges. Sand and gravel, both key ingredients in concrete and construction, are now the most extracted materials in the world, even exceeding fossil fuels. Sand is becoming increasingly scarce globally, and it is now more important than ever to consider alternative building materials in selection and design. The BMIG currently covers the project cycle as it relates to material selection, the material life cycle, and key concepts in environmentally and socially responsible material use. It also covers the most common materials typically used in construction. In 2016, we partnered with Northwestern University's McCormick School of Engineering to expand the number of materials and topics included in the tool, and to develop a more structured framework for capturing, learning, and user feedback. I'll now turn it over to Vidushi to discuss her work at Northwestern on the BMIG.
Hi everyone, happy to participate today. During last spring, a course at Northwestern enabled students to develop the BMIG further. The results were exciting, and we decided to continue working on the project. This summer, I focused on expanding the database, which currently lists 49 building materials, all of their properties, as well as environmental impacts during their entire life cycle. Apart from expanding the database, we also wanted to make the guide easier to use, be able to compare materials, and thereby make effective construction decisions. For this purpose, a sustainable infrastructure decision-making tool was developed. The optimization algorithm is based on minimizing cost as well as environmental impact while keeping the required strength of materials in mind. As a proof of concept, a model house in the Terai region of Nepal was developed, where several building materials were considered for different parts and a Pareto optimal curve was then obtained. We are currently working on expanding the optimization work and are hoping to get valuable inputs from all of you. Some of the questions that would help us proceed are listed in the presentation. We would love to receive your feedback on the optimization and connect further.
Thanks, Vidushi. And as she said, we are actively looking for feedback on these research and tool development questions. So if you're interested in the guide or participating in our research and development, please let us know. Our contact information is in this presentation and available on our handout. Thank you very much, and we look forward to hearing from you.